I pray that she will be prosperous in all the days of her life. She'll get scholarships. She will learn. And she'll not look away from you, God.
Yes, God.
Father, whatever is not lining up in her little body right now, we pray healing.
No.
We pray healing right now, God.
Yes,
touch her, God. Touch her mind, dear God. Close up her ears, God, that she only hear from you.
Yes.
So, Father, we thank you and we praise you. Hold out your two hands. Put them together on top of each other. Open them together. Press down, shaking together, and running over. God loves you. When I say God loves you, He loves you. And you're not moving from it. You're going to hold on to this. And every time that you feel depressed, we'll break that spirit of depression now. Every time you feel that you're alone, know that God is with you. Because you're not too young to feel depressed. How old are you? You're 8 years old. You say 8 is a good number. 8 is a new beginning. This is how life is going to rock you. And when you feel like it's going to rock you like this, you're going to have to speak to God. Get your phone in the meantime. Get your phone. And as I finish, because I need to stop, but you're pulling on me so much. But I thank God that when the pressing comes,
yes.
When the pushing comes, so you step back and you brace yourself. That is how you're going to have to brace yourself, even in your young age.
Yes.
And when you're praying, pray for mommy. Pray hard for mommy. Because mommy is not meeting it too good right now. So you have to pray for mommy. Because God will hear your prayers because of your purity. You're not getting the phone yet. Come over here with us. You have two. You're a doctor, you're a lawyer. Hold on to my trust. Which one are you using now? Alright, get in your contacts and add Jesus. Put Jesus. You have contacts in it?
Yes.
Alright, so Jesus, I have that one here. I want to name Jesus. I contact him.
Yes.
And I get a phone number. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Save the number. You know, them of us someone said Jesus on the telephone.
Yes. Yes.
So every time that you feel like there's any lack in your life, that's the number you're going to call.
Oh my God.
And the answer is going to come because guess what? This way, every time you call that number, you're going to have the word of God open up right beside you.
Yeah.
So although you're up on the phone now, and then every time I'm sitting on your phone, I'm going to wonder if I'm fasting, you know, I'm going to wonder if I Jesus your tattoo. Yeah. Sometimes you're going to sit down in this ministry here. And you're going to call Jesus on them behalf.
Because
Jesus is a poet. I want Mr. Which one? No weapon. No weapon. No weapon. See, this man of God is your father, is your son, is your brother, and your grandfather, and your uncle. Don't let anyone tell you anything bad about him.
Amen. Amen.
I even listen, You shut it down.
Amen.
Mommy, there's purpose in your loins. And don't come off of your knee. No matter how you see him look like him reach because him have church and him a prophet. Mommy, there's nothing like a mother's prayer. And don't feel bad for telling him still. Say, remember, say, me and your mother. Me bring you into this world. So when him do something where you're not pleased about, don't feel bad to say it to him. Because we're not perfect. And everybody look to us for perfection because we say we are prophet or we are evangelist or whoever we is in the fivefold. So mommy, continue to pray for him. Because without your prayers, he would not be able to sit there today. So your prayers for him going forward. When you pray where you normally pray, just make sure it's a purpose. Make sure it's a purpose. Just call out purpose. When it's a prophet, it's a prophet purpose. You are going to turn three times. And this three time we turn, stop. That's how the enemy stops you in your tracks a lot. And you feel like you go and then you come right back. But here we are gonna know. So you must spin your next this time and maybe I'll pick them up to catch you. Because the enemy now gonna stop you in your tracks no more.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Don't stop praying for your picking them. Sometimes they give so much trouble, don't. But what kind of trouble? Wait till the songs, let them come. Are you at the keys? Yeah. Where did my other fella then? Puppy? I'm gonna forget you now. Yeah, man, go and stretch. Stand up and stretch, man. You sit down too comfortable around there. Don't it? You feel comfortable? Come on, the other side. Come on. Listen, say into the prayer. You got an enemy busy in another family here. For whatever reason, it's because they stand with prophets. And the anointing, the prophetic anointing is so much on your life that your sons are bearing it. And my kids bear it because of that too. But your sons are going to make sure that you're in no want. So what you're going through now is because the enemy is seeing your purpose. What you're going through now is only a next part of the journey and the testimony of God's goodness and the testimony of a mother's prayer and a testimony when you have a prophet who will see you and talk to you over. And sometimes we go through some things because as them so our ears are. But you're going to start to listen now. You're going to start to grasp now. You could have gone to Sabell Church. You could have gone to CLC. You could have gone to all the different churches then. It's you. Because no matter how much church you go, God see your heart. So it's your heart got to work off of. So even if you go out of church and sing you there, I beg God this, if your heart is not where God wants your heart to be, remember say, oh, that case you're going to go. Because you have the last say in what happens with this case. Saints, pray for him. Pray for him. And pray for this woman of God. Don't question why prophet love her so much. Don't question it no more. Do not question why prophet love her so much. Don't question why she love prophet so much. That has nothing to do with any of you. It's the greatest thing when this is somebody who have a good heart, stand with a man or a woman of God. When it's supposed to push them even further. And I try to get in a little self in the midlight. Nothing what them tell you about prophet if you believe. Lie them I tell.
Yeah, right.
lie them a tell. But let me tell you something. We as Christians sometimes are we broke down. But I always make a little excuse for us, because not all of us that raise our hands are delivered. We won't get delivered in us. Some of us really won't get delivered in the prophet, but we just not get delivered yet because we not fully commit to God. 3 o'clock. So this is the end of when your 3 hours of prayer would end. And sometimes I'm going to go in on the fourth watch. He says, me look at my watch, it's 3 o'clock. Last time I really looked on my watch, it was 12. So he said, the word is real for you. Lift up your mother. Hold him over, don't let him go. Because it's the same way you pray for that other person that you and I know, and the anointing, where you pray, make sure say, everything work out, and the same thing, the same prayer. I saw when he held his hand down, say it's not by chance that the Lord leads you to come back and hold him out, because that's where I say, same way or you release that one from the case. It's the same.
Hallelujah!
Way.
Hallelujah!
I know time is far spent, I'm going to have a time to expire, I don't know that. I wouldn't lean on the staff. And as I lean today to give the last lesson, mommy, throw me a kiss. Throw me one more, mommy. Throw me one more, mommy. God love you so much. God love you so much, and your blessing is on its way. Amen. Remember me tell you that your blessing. Hold up your man. You're gonna be his ear on. Yeah, go shut up about this time. You ain't get tired yet? I'm not going now. Because, you see, you don't forget tired, mommy.
Understand.
Why you are going through what you're going through. So as your hand gets so tired and weak and weary, see you two people there, man? You hold it off. And that's why I'm not forget. Believe me. Because the mothers, your daughters, where are they? She has 5 kids. So that's why the grace is upon you, because we know 5 means grace.
5 means grace, yeah.
So at this juncture of your life, when you are worried about him, stop for a moment. Release him. I'm going to seriously say release him. It's not a joke, release this now. Because you have to pray as a mother. So don't get me wrong when I say release him. But as you pray, you have to pray and believe and feel. You know them say you feel light when you are walking in the spirit? And so you have to feel light. So when you feel light, when you pray, you know say God got it. Because he said, his yoke is easy.
Burden is light.
So what you have to do? Feel light. Just like how him feel light with him, how much burden him I carry for me. Marvin. No, you know why I'm here to say that. Because it's your man pushing. Marvin. You can come. You have to brace yourself. And my hand is on your heart. Because God wants you to purify your heart. He wants to pull some things out of your heart. Stop carrying it in your heart. If you don't let it go, you're going to bear the consequences of it. You can't fight fire with fire. Never fight it with prayer, man of God. Father, we thank you for today.
Yes.
We never tell him to let go, you know. And we never tell him to let go. Because in life, as much as we don't want to believe it, pain never come. I need you to come this way. I'm gonna turn my back to them because I want you to face them. Man of God says, so who is Nanny Mitchell? This one. He just passed. So it's a hard time for me. I turn my back to them because I want you to face them. Because the giants that are coming in your life, you have to face them. You have to put on the old armor of God. And you have to face it. Mary and Rose, put on a big panty, big man. You have to put on a big man grief. And face it. That's what the problem is, distraction. And I say I don't want to come up on just for you. But the enemy will whisper all kinds of things in your ears. And the distracting spirit that's following you. Till the man of God say, isn't that what you want to say to the death angel? No. Once you surrender your all to God, He's been calling you forever. And someday you hear the voice and say, "Trump." No, so I lay your hand, the hand is supposed to jump. So the next time I lay your hand, the hand is supposed to stay. So. But we come against every plan of the enemy today.
Amen. Amen.
We'll cramp and paralyze
the
plan of the enemy today. Yes. I was going to tell you to move it and you know. I know. So you already, you so prophetic. That it is a sin for you not to be speaking over the lives of God people. Because already you see what Mega tell you.
Yeah.
So it means that you don't only see in a straight line, you see around the corner. Am I wrong or am I right? I don't ask many people that. You're the second person I ask. I'm coming knowing me I hear from God. But I want you to believe, so I really hear from God. Because you don't believe easily. A guy can't tell you anything and you listen to him. But well, let me tell you something. It's a way me and Mitchell today. You untied? Ah, yeah, man. I've been untied.
Wallet, man.
At a pain, I'm not ever come.
Yeah.
You have to go knock off wallet.
Yeah, a chilling girl.
You're going to make your family so proud. When you turn your life around 100%. Don't worry about money because that's your problem. The one rich. But you know, say, I did have a woolly for money one time. Woolly, woolly, woolly. But I say woolly. Woolly for money. I mean woolly. I mean, you know, Donald Trump money, but me have money. I'm going to live comfortable. Buy me Gucci, buy me Louis Vuitton, buy me everything. You know what? They have it. Them beer things. But you want me to tell you something? You never happy like when I'm happy now.
Hallelujah.
And you know why I'm never happy? Because sometimes I say, boy, God, my mind get back some of the money still. You know? But you know, I wasn't happy. God wasn't using me in this to be a blessing to you. And there's nothing more fulfilling than when you're operating in the gift that God has given you. Because as the man of God spoke about the talents earlier, He has given you the talents and He's coming back to ask you, what have you done with them? Them tell us they have goat mouth. Nobody ever tell you that yet. Them tell us they have goat mouth. Why you think I saw them tell me to say me have goat mouth? Because our parents, my mother never did understand, say, is a prophet that was on my life. You know, let's go to me. So because you have the prophetic so strong in you, you have to just clean up your act. So God can use you. And then you're going to see the money flow. But until you clean up your act and start operating that prophetic gift, you're not going to see the manifestation of God's glory. And I tell you the truth. I mean, I'm not a judgment prophet. But sometimes, my feet just go hard. Because when you lay in bed hard, while you're sleeping, it's hard. You see again? And you know what the Lord is saying to me? It's not that you're distracted, but you're always on the edge. Nobody can do you nothing if you stay in a God. You don't have to be afraid that something that come for you or somebody that come for you or somebody want to do something. So it's not even that you're distracted, you know, it's just because you depend, you always depend on the reflex. Sometimes you have to just rest back in your arm and say, wherever I come, the dark them out there to catch me, I will send them back. So we pray against every death angel that would want to come and steal your purpose, your gift, your future, your everything that the conquer worm and the palmer worm and the caterpillar has stolen from you. We ask God now to restore it a thousandfold and let you walk in your overflow, and the manifestation must come. So Father, I thank you for this man of God. I thank you, Lord God, for your blessing him. Let me tell you what is so strong and good about you. You don't, apart from when the tool can tie your tongue right here, you can look in my eye then. A lot of people can't look in my eye then. That says volume for you. That says when you see demon come, you can have the power to speak to them. But you have to walk in a manifestation. Don't worry about where your brethren are going to say. They're going to glad to them know you. Because when you lay your hand on them and they pick them, they're going to heal. When you're speaking of them life, whatever you say, I'm going to manifest just like prophet. Prophet won't give the gift and you don't want to take it. Because you're afraid that enough time, you're not going to like the head by that husband for years. And I'll be the moderator and I say, well, now we're going to have Minister Phillips on the stage. And God said, no. Come in front. Come and lead. Not my husband, but you are going to lead some other people, women and men, to Christ. So you are an evangelist. You have the prophetic gift. Lord Jesus, you know how much people that beg for what you have, Master? People that pay millions and millions and millions of dollars for the gift for God give you. Because you're one different. You hear me, I tell you? Walk in it. So break every death angel off of your life right now in the name of Jesus. We call for Gabriel. We call for Michael. We call them for now to fight on your behalf. You know, you read the book of Daniel? When Daniel prayed, and Daniel said, where are you there? Gabriel and Michael said, look, you know, I said, we are war with some people for you, know, for the king of Persia, you know. Are you that, you know? You understand what I'm saying? So God has sent you a blessing. But right now it's all up because of your disobedience. So now you're going to be obedient. Come on, saints, I want you to pray for him.
Hallelujah.
Daddy is gone, but not forgotten. Daddy was a Christian. So where is Daddy now? You're thinking in heaven. Tell me the truth. You're thinking in heaven, but it was not Christian. So in your heart, I'm going to ask you a serious question. Do you think you can still live a life not being a Christian and being in heaven? Answer God later. You don't have to answer me because I know how you're staying. I want nobody know your business. But it's okay. But I ask you that question and I leave you with that question. Because you said Daddy was not Christian and you think Daddy is in heaven. So you are a Christian? So where you think you're going to go? Answer that. God is going to answer you. Because I know you know the answer. Because if you never know the answer, you would not be sitting here today. Because you want to do it. You want to make that step. So I'm going to turn over to prophet now. Prophet is going to call an altar call. And let's see what God is going to tell you between now and the time when prophet called the altar call. Because the souls are important to God. So we just thank God for you right now, man of God. You hear me call you? Man of God.
Amen.
You know, so them come evangelists, them ordained me 2006. But me little bit, them call me all kind of things, all kind of names. And sometimes people say, why me like the name evangelist? Because one time, they only call me nothing like that. Dance hall, everywhere me did. So nobody not call you a dance hall evangelist, really? And what you hear about? So right now, I'm going to tell you this. God is calling you. Harden not your heart. Me never come here. You're on tired too. Are you finger them at the gun hand? Okay. I love your spirit. And you know what? You're going to be so serious for God that a guy can't even take you off right when you start walking the Bible. And that's all. You know, Harden? Yeah, tell us it don't Harden. So if God never send me, come from which part me that's there today for nobody, he send me for you. So make sure that when prophet call out of God, it says something to you. But I know you're going to send them to go to the place. You know, listen, tears is a language that only Jesus understands. And only God understands what it is that he's going through now. Because it's not easy to lose a loved one. I just came for a funeral for one of the pastors that preached from me at Mandela Park. And he's a young man, 42 years old, did the altar call at Mandela Park on Good Friday for me. And he met in a bad car accident and died on May 9th. And I'm telling you, that man walked the park, walk Mandela Park, and call the people in to come serve God. If you're here today and you don't know the Lord as a Savior, come make prophet tell away for them. Saints, all I ask of you is for you to pray my strength. All I ask of you is for you to keep me in your prayers. All I ask of you is for you to just ask God to continue to bless the ministry that he has given me so I can get the souls into the kingdom. I'm not too big to ask for your prayers because I want God to use me like never before so souls can be saved, delivered, and set free. And as I pray, ask for prayers for me. I ask for prayers for this man of God. I love him so much. Boy, every day that I talk about prophet, but I never really experience the true and living God in a man of God in Jamaica like this. And I thank God for him. Because the blessings that he has cast over me. It's a long time you don't get them the kind of blessings. Trust me. I go from a live, but I can do a live and I put in another 2 hours on Facebook and trust and believe my effort about this. Because this is good. What you have is good food. No, you eat some rice and peas and chicken when I go for going to eat. I mean, I talk to no out. So Father, I would just thank you. I thank you for everything that you have used me to do today. God, I ask your blessings upon your people. And Father, as I turn back over to the man of God to do the altar call, I pray in the name of Jesus that souls will be saved, delivered, and set free. Father, I pray that none of these words shall come back void. I come against every backlash. I come against every envious spirit, every covetous spirit, every unforgiving spirit. I come against everything that would want to take your people into the pit of hell. And Father, I ask you to raise them up into another dimension. And Father, every word that has been spoken today, I pray that it will not fall to stony ground, but fall in the hearts of your people. So Father, I give you honor and I give you praise. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You can put on a hand now. That is. When the shaking coming, you have to stand up, right? When the breaking coming, that's what Jacqueline Carr said. When the shaking are coming, when the breaking are coming. Right. Look, you see? Look on the smile on daddy's face. Oh, when the shaking are coming. But smile when the shaking and the breaking are coming. You may have okay, daddy. May them be alone. Thank you, baby.
Oh my. All right, now tell him. God, no easy. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Boy. What a mighty God you serve. I want to give everyone. From Miss Russell, who did have to leave because she had to leave for a reason. But before we call an altar call, amen, praise God. Sister Reese has an item. Well, she never did today. She should have been asleep. So, so she's not gonna be long. But let's see. See what she's doing. She's carrying her cross.
My song shall praise Him.
Some great things in this ministry for Melody.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Reese carrying her cross. Amen. That's the sister Bev licking her shoulder. That means that she wasn't worshiping the way she was. Guys, innocent. Yeah, man. So thank you, Sister Phillips, for let you feel pain. That's what Jesus been through. And the song, slap your hands together for her, Reese. Dujan, what part?
Yeah, man.
Come on, put your hands to that for Dujan. It's a touching song. Dance was wonderful. It was awesome, and she demonstrated. It's a ministry right here.
Yeah.
And I love how Dujan, like, the crumbs of time.
Yes. Yeah.
Crumbs of time.
Number one.
Yes.
Number one.
Dujan is an actor, you know.
Yeah.
Dujan wear on tight pants, Pamela, as he come here. Glory. Yes, man. So Dujan is an actor. Praise God. Put your hands up for Sister Phillips. Wow, may I tell you, everything what she said, I'm glad. Me and she know have them discussion here.
Yes.
This is the second time she's preaching here.
Yeah.
And we have never had no discussion board. Nobody in the church.
Sure.
So God did her here.
Yes.
Everything, if you really catch what God is doing. Where's the sister we were talking to earlier? As he said, well, even a sister was sitting right here, a baby.
Yeah, yeah.
Come here, sister. Come give your testimony. First time. Who invite you?
Oh, my daughter.
Which one then?
Yeah,
pretty girl, eh?
Sister and brothers, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
You know, through my ears, I've been very difficult.
You won't be afraid.
People hate me without a cause. I have some sisters and brothers in the state. And they used to correspond with me, send me things and so, and they just cut off me just like that. I've been doing nothing at all, doing nobody. I'm going to school, I get favor from the teacher, the students fight against me. People take off my clothes.